Daily Evening Prayer. Wednesday, September 18th, 2024. To the Lord our God belong mercy and forgiveness, for we have rebelled against him. Dearly beloved, the scriptures teach us to acknowledge our many sins and offenses, not concealing them from our Heavenly Father, but confessing them with humble and obedient hearts, that we may obtain forgiveness by his infinite goodness and mercy. We ought at all times humbly to acknowledge our sins before Almighty God, but especially when we come together in his presence to give thanks for the great benefits we have received at his hands, to declare his most worthy praise, to hear his holy word, and to ask for ourselves and on behalf of others those things which are necessary for our life and our salvation. Therefore, draw near with me to the throne of heavenly grace. Almighty and most merciful Father, we have erred and strayed from your ways like lost sheep. We have followed too much the devices and desires of our own hearts. We have offended against your holy laws. We have left undone those things which we ought to have done, and we have done those things which we ought not to have done. And apart from your grace, there is no health in us. O Lord, have mercy upon us. Spare all those who confessed your faults. Restore all those who are penitent according to your promises declared to all people in Christ Jesus our Lord. And grant, O most merciful Father, for his sake, that we may now live a godly, righteous, and sober life. To the glory of your holy name. Amen. Grant to your faithful people, merciful Lord, pardon and peace, that we may be cleansed from all our sins and serve you with a quiet mind. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. O Lord, open our lips, and our mouth shall proclaim your praise. O God, make speed to save us. O Lord, make haste to help us. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. Praise the Lord. The Lord's name be praised. O gladsome light, pure brightness of the ever-living Father in heaven, O Jesus Christ, holy and blessed. Now as we come to the setting of the sun and our eyes behold the vesper light, we sing your praises, O God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. You are worthy at all times to be praised by happy voices, O Son of God, O Giver of life, and to be glorified through all the worlds. The Lord as King has put on glorious apparel. The Lord has put on his apparel and girded himself with strength. He has made the round world so sure that it cannot be moved. Ever since the world began, your throne has been established. You are from everlasting. The floods have risen, O Lord. The floods have lifted up their voice. The floods have lifted up their waves. Mightier than the sound of many waters, mightier than the waves of the sea, the Lord who dwells on high is mightier. Your testimonies, O Lord, are very sure. Holiness adorns your house forever. O Lord God, to whom vengeance belongs, O God, to whom vengeance belongs, show yourself. Arise, O Judge of the world, and reward the proud according to their deserving. O Lord, how long shall the ungodly, how long shall the ungodly triumph? How long shall all evildoers speak so disdainfully to make such proud boasting? They smite down your people, O Lord, and tremble and trouble your heritage. They murder the widow and the stranger and put the fatherless to death. And yet they said, the Lord shall not see, neither shall the God of Jacob regard it. Take heed, you unwise among the people. O you fools, when will you understand? He who planted the ear, shall he not see? He who planted the ear, shall he not hear? Or he who made the eye, shall he not see? Or he who nurtures the nations, he who teaches humanity knowledge, shall he not punish? The Lord knows the thoughts of man, that they are but vain. Blessed is the one whom you chasten, O Lord, and whom you teach your law, that you may give him patience in times. Give him patience in time of adversity until the pit is dug for the ungodly. For the Lord will not fail his people, neither will he forsake his inheritance, but righteousness shall return to the place of judgment, and all those who are true of heart shall follow it. Who will rise up with me against the wicked? Or who will take my part against the evildoers? If the Lord had not helped me, my soul would soon have dwelt in the land of silence. But when I said, my foot has slipped, your mercy, O Lord, held me up. In the multitude of the sorrows that I had in my heart, your comforts refreshed my soul. Will you have anything to do with the counsel of wickedness, which turns evil into law? They gather themselves together against the soul of the righteous and condemn the innocent to death. But the Lord is my refuge, and my God is the rock of my confidence. He shall recompense them for their wickedness and destroy them in their own malice. Indeed, the Lord our God shall destroy them. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. A reading from the prophet Zephaniah, beginning with the third chapter of the first verse. Woe to her who is rebellious and defiled, the oppressive city. She obeyed no voice, she accepted no discipline, she did not trust in the Lord, she did not approach her God. Her leaders within her are roaring lions, her judges are wolves at evening. They have no bones to gnaw in the morning. Her prophets are insolent, treacherous men. Her priests have profaned the sanctuary. They have done violence to the law. The Lord is righteous within her. He will do no injustice. Every morning he brings his justice to light. He does not fail. But the criminal knows no shame. I have eliminated nations. Their corner towers are deserted. I have laid waste their streets with no one passing by. Their cities have been laid waste without a person, without an inhabitant. I said, you will certainly revere me. You will accept discipline. So her dwelling will not be eliminated in accordance with everything that I have stipulated for her. Instead, they were eager to corrupt all their deeds. Therefore, wait for me, declares the Lord, for the day when I rise up as a witness. Indeed, my decision is to gather nations, to assemble kingdoms, to pour out on them my indignation, all my burning anger, for all the earth will be devoured by the fire of my zeal. For then I will restore to the people's pure lips, so that all of them may call on the name of the Lord, to serve him shoulder to shoulder from beyond the rivers of Ethiopia. My worshippers, my dispersed ones, will bring my offerings. On that day you will feel no shame because of all your deeds by which you have rebelled against me. For then I will remove from your midst your proud, arrogant ones, and you will never again be haughty on my holy mountain. But I will leave among you a humble and lowly people, and they will take refuge in the name of the Lord. The remnant of Israel will do no wrong and tell no lies, nor will a deceitful tongue be found in their mouths, for they will feed and lie down with no one to frighten them. Shout for joy, daughter of Zion, shout in triumph, Israel. Rejoice and triumph with all your heart, daughter of Jerusalem. The Lord has taken away his judgments against you. He has cleared away your enemies. The King of Israel, the Lord, is in your midst. You will no longer fear disaster. On that day it will be said to Jerusalem, do not be afraid, Zion. Do not let your hands fall limp. The Lord your God is in your midst, a victorious warrior. He will rejoice over you and with joy. He will be quiet in his love. He will rejoice over you with shouts of joy. I will gather those who are worried about the appointed feasts. They came from you, Zion. The disgrace of exile is a burden on them. Behold, I am going to deal at that time with all your oppressors. I will save those who limp and gather the scattered, and I will turn their shame into praise and famine in all the earth. At that time I will bring you in, even at the time when I gather you together. Indeed, I will make you famous and praiseworthy among all the peoples of the earth when I restore your fortunes before your eyes, says the Lord. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. My soul magnifies the Lord, and my spirit rejoices in God, my Savior, for he has regarded the lowliness of his handmaiden. But behold, from now on all generations will call me blessed, for he that is mighty has magnified me, and holy is his name. And his mercy is on those who fear him throughout all generations. He has shown the strength of his arm, he has scattered the proud in the imagination of their hearts, he has brought down the mighty from their thrones, and has exalted the humble and meek. He has filled the hungry with good things, and the rich he has sent empty away. He, remembering his mercy, has helped his servant Israel as he promised to our fathers, Abraham, and his seed forever. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. A reading from the Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to St. Matthew, beginning with the 13th chapter, the 44th verse. The kingdom of heaven is like a treasure hidden in the field, which a man found and hid again, and from joy over it, he goes and sells everything that he has and buys that field. Again, the kingdom of heaven is like a merchant seeking fine pearls, and upon finding one pearl of great value, he went and sold everything that he had and bought it. Again, the kingdom of heaven is like a dragnet that was cast into the sea and gathered fish of every kind. And when it was filled, they pulled it up on the beach, and they sat down and gathered the good fish into containers, but the bad they threw away. So it will be at the end of the age. The angels will come forth and remove the wicked from among the righteous, and they will throw them into the furnace of fire. In that place there will be weeping and gnashing of teeth. Have you understood all these things? They said to him, yes. And Jesus said to them, therefore every scribe who has become a disciple of the kingdom of heaven is like a head of a household who brings out of his treasure new things and old. When Jesus had finished these parables, he departed from there, and he came to his hometown and began teaching them in their synagogue, with the result that they were astonished and said, where did this man acquire this wisdom and these miraculous powers? Is this not the carpenter's son? Is his mother not called Mary, and his brothers James, Joseph, Simon, and Judas? And his sisters, are they not all with us? Where then did this man acquire all these things? And they took offense at him. But Jesus said to them, a prophet is not dishonored, except in his hometown and in his own household. And he did not do many miracles there because of their unbelief. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. Lord, now let your servant depart in peace according to your word, for my eyes have seen your salvation, which you have prepared before the face of all people, to be a light to lighten the Gentiles, and to be the glory of your people Israel. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. The Lord be with you and with your spirit. Let us pray. Lord, have mercy upon us. Christ, have mercy upon us. Lord, have mercy upon us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. O Lord, show your mercy upon us, and grant us your salvation. O Lord, guide those who govern us and lead us in the way of justice and truth. Clothe your ministers with righteousness and let your people sing with joy. O Lord, save your people and bless your inheritance. Give peace in our time, O Lord, and defend us by your mighty power. Let not the needy, O Lord, be forgotten, nor the hope of the poor be taken away. Create in us clean hearts, O God, and take not your Holy Spirit from us. O God, you led your holy apostles to ordain ministers in every place. Grant that your church, under the guidance of the Holy Spirit, may choose suitable persons for the ministry of word and sacrament, and may uphold them in their work for the extension of your kingdom through the great shepherd and bishop of our souls, Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. O God, because without you we are not able to please you, mercifully grant that your Holy Spirit may in all things direct and rule our hearts through Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. O God, the life of all who live, the light of the faithful, the strength of those who labor, and the repose of the dead, we thank you for the blessings of the day that is past, and humbly ask for your protection through the coming night. Bring us in safety to the morning hours through him who died and rose again for us, your Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen. Keep watch, dear Lord, with those who walk or watch or weep this night, and give your angels charge over those who sleep. Tend the sick, Lord Christ, give rest to the weary, bless the dying, soothe the suffering, pity the afflicted, shield the joyous, and all for your love's sake. Amen. O God, the Father, creator of heaven and earth, have mercy upon us. O God, the Son, redeemer of the world, have mercy upon us. O God, the Holy Spirit, sanctifier of the faithful, have mercy upon us. O Holy, blessed, and glorious Trinity, one God, have mercy upon us. Remember not, Lord Jesus, our offenses, nor the offenses of our forebears, neither reward us according to our sins. Spare us, good Lord, spare your people, whom you have redeemed as your with your most precious blood, and by your mercy preserve us forever. Spare us, good Lord, from all evil and wickedness, from sin, from the works and assaults of the devil, from your wrath and everlasting condemnation. Good Lord, deliver us from all blindness of heart, from pride, vanity, and hypocrisy, from envy, hatred, and malice, and from all lack of charity. Good Lord, deliver us from all disorder and sinful affections, and from all the deceits of the world, the flesh, and the devil. Good Lord, deliver us from all false doctrine, heresy, and schism, from hardness of heart and contempt of your word and commandments. Good Lord, deliver us from lightning and tempest, from earthquake, fire, and flood, from plague, pestilence, and famine. Good Lord, deliver us from all oppression, conspiracy, and rebellion, from violence, battle, and murder, and from dying suddenly and unprepared. Good Lord, deliver us by the mystery of your holy incarnation, by your holy nativity and submission to the law, by your baptism, fasting, and temptation. Good Lord, deliver us by your agony and bloody sweat, by your cross and passion, by your precious death and burial. Good Lord, deliver us by your glorious resurrection and ascension, by the sending of the Holy Spirit, by your heavenly intercession, and by your coming again in power and great glory. Good Lord, deliver us in all times of tribulation, in all times of prosperity, in the hour of death, and in the day of judgment. Good Lord, deliver us. We sinners beseech you to hear us, O Lord God, that it may please you to rule and govern your holy church universal in the right way. We beseech you to hear us, good Lord, to illumine all bishops, priests, and deacons with true knowledge and understanding of your word, and that both by their preaching and living they may show it accordingly. We beseech you to hear us, good Lord. Send forth laborers into your harvest, to prosper their work by your Holy Spirit, to make your saving health known unto all nations, and to hasten the coming of your kingdom. We beseech you to hear us, good Lord, to give all your people increase of grace to hear your word with humility, to receive it with pure affection, and to bring forth the fruit of the Spirit. We beseech you to hear us, good Lord, to bring into the way of truth all who have erred and are deceived. We beseech you to hear us, good Lord, to give us a heart to love you and fear you, and diligently to keep your commandments. We beseech you to hear us, good Lord, to bless and keep all your people. We beseech you to hear us, good Lord, that it may please you to rule the hearts of your servant, our national leaders, and all others in authority, that they may do justice and show mercy and walk humbly before you. Beseech you to hear us, good Lord, to bless and guide all judges, giving them grace to execute justice and to maintain truth. We beseech you to hear us, good Lord, to bless and keep our armed forces by sea and land and air, to shield them in all dangers and adversities. We beseech you to hear us, good Lord, to bless and protect all who serve their communities by their labor and learning. We beseech you to hear us, good Lord, to give and preserve for us and for others the bountiful fruits of the earth, so that at the harvest we all may enjoy them. We beseech you to hear us, good Lord, to make wars to cease in all the world, and to give to all nations unity, peace, and concord. We beseech you to hear us, good Lord, that it may please you to show mercy on all prisoners and captives, refugees, the homeless and the hungry, and all those who are desolate and oppressed. We beseech you to hear us, good Lord, to preserve all who are in danger by reason of their work or travel. We beseech you to hear us, good Lord, to strengthen the bonds of those in holy matrimony, to uphold the widowed and abandoned, and to comfort all whose homes are torn by strife. We beseech you to hear us, good Lord, to protect the unborn and their parents, and to preserve all women in childbirth. We beseech you to hear us, good Lord, to care for those who have lost children or face infertility, and to provide for young children and orphans, we beseech you to hear us, good Lord. To visit the lonely and those who grieve, to strengthen all who suffer in mind, body, or spirit, and to comfort with your presence those who are failing and infirm, we beseech you to hear us, good Lord. To support, help, and deliver all who are in danger, necessity, and tribulation, we beseech you to hear us, good Lord. To have mercy upon all people, we beseech you to hear us, good Lord. That it may please you to give us true repentance, to forgive us all our sin, negligence, and ignorance, and to endue us with the grace of your Holy Spirit, to amend our lives according to your holy word, we beseech you to hear us, good Lord. To forgive our enemies, persecutors, and slanderers, and to turn their hearts, we beseech you to hear us, good Lord. To strengthen those who stand, to encourage the faint-hearted, to raise up those who fall, and finally to be done Satan under our feet, we beseech you to hear us, good Lord. To grant to all the faithful departed eternal life and peace, we beseech you to hear us, good Lord. To grant that we may attain to your heavenly kingdom, we beseech you to hear us, good Lord. Son of God, we beseech you to hear us. Son of God, we beseech you to hear us. O Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world, have mercy upon us. O Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world, have mercy upon us. O Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world, grant us your peace. O Christ, hear us. O Christ, hear us. Lord, have mercy. Christ, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us today our daily bread, and forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. And save us from the time of trial, and deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. O Lord, arise and help us, and deliver us for your name's sake. O God, we have heard with our ears, and our forebears have declared to us, in the noble works that you did in their days, and in the time before them. O Lord, arise and help us, and deliver us for your name's sake. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. O Lord, arise and help us, and deliver us for your name's sake. From our enemies, defend us, O Christ. Graciously behold our afflictions. With pity, behold the sorrows of our hearts. Mercifully forgive the sins of your people. In favor, hear our prayers. O Son of David, have mercy upon us. Be pleased to hear us, O Christ. Graciously hear us, O Christ. Graciously hear us, O Lord Christ. Let us pray. Look mercifully, O Father, on our infirmities, and for the glory of your name, rescue us from all those evils we now endure, and grant that in all our troubles we may put our whole trust and confidence in your mercy, serving you in holiness and purity of life. To your honor and glory through our only mediator and advocate, Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Almighty God, Father of all mercies, we, your unworthy servants, give you humble thanks for all your goodness and loving kindness to us and to all whom you have made. We bless you for our creation, preservation, and all the blessings of this life, but above all, for your immeasurable love and the redemption of the world by our Lord Jesus Christ, for the means of grace and for the hope of glory. And we pray, give us such an awareness of your mercies that with truly thankful hearts we may show forth your praise, not only with our lips, but in our lives, by giving up ourselves to your service and by walking before you in holiness and righteousness all our days. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, to whom with you and the Holy Spirit be honor and glory throughout all ages. Amen. Almighty God, you have given us grace at this time with one accord to make our common supplications to you, and you have promised through your well-beloved Son that when two or three are gathered together in his name, you will grant their requests. Fulfill now, Lord, our desires and petitions as may be best for us, granting us in this world knowledge of your truth, and in the age to come, life everlasting. Amen. Let us bless the Lord. Thanks be to God. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us all, evermore. Amen.